Did you just fall into being an expression judge, or you wanted to?
No, that's the story. I had a good friend, gosh, back in, when would that have been? Somewhere in the early 80s, I guess, or mid to early 80s. I had been regent, which was like president, which is now like the team manager of the region. Well, I had been the regent. And I had met people here and around and stuff. And so I worked in the regional government and stuff. And so I was asked to be, now they have an education direction committee for the entire organization. At that point, they had an administrative and a music direction committee. And I got asked to be on the administrative direction committee. Met a girl on there, and we just clicked. Her name was Bobby Dollins. She had short hair like me. She was funny as heck. She used to MC. We used to have MCs that told jokes and stuff at the contest. She was just, you know, very quick of mind. And so we, you know, just became really dear friends, and she lived in California. And people would call us Tweedledee and Tweedledum just because we reacted the same to everything. And so through the years, we, you know, kept in touch and everything, and she was an expression judge. And she said to me, "You have to become a judge." And I said, "Well, I'll think about that. You know, that's the last thing I had thought on my mind." Well, she got cancer. Started out with breast cancer, and then it moved up into her jaw, and then finally to her brain. But after she had her jaw and the surgery, she was here to visit with me and stayed with me for a while. And she said, "I'm not kidding. You have to be a judge, and you have to promise me that you'll be an expression judge." So I never had a choice, you know. Right? She doesn't know because I, you know, she passed away before she ever knew. But she knows, you know.
How many years have you judged?
20. I am retiring from that,
yeah,
too.
You said.
Yeah.
The travel,
yeah,
is.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, that's the hard part.
But do you like judging?
I love judging, yes. Yes. I like coaching best than anything, because then you have a chance to really get personal with people. When you're writing down stuff, you know, your hope.
Then you don't get a chance.
You don't get a chance, you know. And sometimes they'll call and say, or, you know, write and say, you know, "What did you mean by this?" Or if we can talk, that's even great. And they go, "Oh."
Now, do they all know that the expression judge is listening, not looking?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I think so. If they ever look down in the pit, they'll see we're not, not looking. Yeah, I think that's the only one that's...
Who is judging then the visual presentation?
That's the showmanship judge. Right. And she's the one that looks, yeah, and watches all of that. And, you know, everything from costumes to makeup to
but you need to try to keep your judgment only on the area.
Right, and fortunately, they've kind of expanded these a little bit just because we used to, as an expression judge, I couldn't mention that somebody was singing out of tune, and
no,
which is impossible.
Can't.
Well, I can't say you're singing out of tune, but I'll say you're lacking musicality, and if they look that up, it, you know, tells them,
yeah,
they weren't singing in tune. but you know, we do everything from the vowels and the diphthongs and the interpretation and the tempo and all of those things, and then you get into the better part, it's emotional communication and finesse and, you know, all these things that are there, but there's a lot of just the detail stuff, but I never sit there and say, "Okay, how many diphthongs did they turn?" You know, I don't care.
Mm-hmm.
I just want them to turn them so I can understand the
it's
words.
It's more of an overall.
It is, yeah, it really is, you know, and so it's a little bit, there's a little bit more freedom there than there was in the past, but you know, sometimes you just hear stuff that, and we do watch sometimes because it's just so good. There's nothing you want to, because we have to write all this stuff,
yeah.
And you finally get through and you go, I've written two lines, you know, because you want to just watch and enjoy, and
mm-hmm.
Usually those are the people that come up high, you know. But it's fun. I've done, I don't know, probably 10, 12 internationals, I guess.
Wow.
That's got where then I couldn't do them. Is often because we were competing on the competitions.
Yeah. How long
also.
Is your day
that
you're judging?
Oh God, if you're international, it's forever.
So you don't have, in ballroom dancing, we'll have a panel, and that panel works maybe 2 hours, and you go straight through.
Yeah, and you got the quartets the day before. See, in Region 4 where we are, we used to have as many as 50 quartets competing in our region.
Wow.
I mean, judges hated to come here because it's such a long day. I think the largest one I did this year was 32 quartets.
In a day?
In a day, yeah. And then courses, just depends on the region, you know. I think the fewest I've ever done was 11 or 12. But sometimes when you go to international, you're going to have you've got all the regions plus 10 mile cards, so you're going to have 40-something.
So then how many days?
The quartets, international, the quartets sing on Wednesday. Thursday is the chorus semifinals. The top 10 from Wednesday sing on Friday. And then on Saturday is the top 10 from...
So for that whole event, the same...
You've got 4 days,
judges will be...
same judges do them all, which is unusual. Now, that's not the case. I'm lying. That's the way it is at a regional. At international, mm-hmm. you either do quartets or courses. But you still have...
But the expression judge or the musicality judge does the entire contest.
No. I just lied. I was thinking about a regional because you do all of them. But when you go to international, you either do the quartets or the choruses. And you do the Rising Star, except this year is going to be at IES. You sit through a morning of watching level takes that we get into our heads and we're all kind of on the same pack. This is what an A course, this is what a B course looks like. We go through all these things and we discuss every one. You know, what kind of score would I give them?
Mm-hmm.
Just so that we're all kind of have our heads on the same direction. But we've gone through a lot of training to get there, so.
Yeah.
A lot of training. But anyway, but it's a delight. I think mostly just to know that there's nothing better than somebody saying, I loved your comments, thanks, you really helped us, you know. That's a good way, so. But anyway, so it's been a delightful life, and it's not going to stop. It's just, you know. I watch my daughter, she was the Queen of Harmony. Her quartet won the International Championship in 2006. Five or six, I always get confused. Anyway, yeah, and that was a treat, you know, to see your offspring doing that. And the year after they won, I had a heart attack, and out of the blue. And the contest was in Calgary year.
Long way.
Right. And she was already out there with her quartet because they had to sing around as chambers or whatever. And so my best friend and her husband were going to pick us up. Pick me up. We were ready to go to the airport. So I'm all packed, and I'm sitting here waiting, and... all of a sudden, I started having these chest pains. Like somebody was sitting on me, and I couldn't figure out what was going on. I thought, oh my gosh, what's happening? I think I'll go take an aspirin. Then I kind of come to, and I'm on the floor, and there's baby aspirin all over the floor. So I got up and called 911. And so while I'm waiting for them to come, I called my friend Kathy. Oh, she said, I said, hey, I'm having a heart attack. She said, me too, I can't wait to get there.
She thought you were joking.
Yeah, she thought I was just ready to, you know. Anyway, so that's all started, and Carrie came back from Calgary, and for about 6 months, it wasn't that long, I think I started directing that before then, but we had a show coming up, and she said, Mom, do you need any help? And we had an assistant director, but there was no way she was going to take the whole show.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this was a, you know, theater show type thing. And I said, I love it. So I sat in the audience and watched that whole show. And then when that was over, then it was kind of like, I'll stay as long as you need me to, you know. And then it became so good for both of us that we just
co-directed.
Started doing it, yeah. So, but water, that's
better. Well, she'll be taking over.
She's taking over, yeah. So it's really interesting, yes. But, I figure they always say you need to groom your successor. Well, I groomed my successor.
Okay.